You're live with BBC News. South Korea's Liberal Opposition Party has won a landslide majority in the country's general election to retain control of the parliament. South Koreans were voting to elect all 300 members of the parliament, not the president. But the vote was seen as a midterm referendum on the current president, Yoon Suk-yeol, who has been in power for 2 years. South Korea media is reporting that the prime minister and most of the senior staff of the presidential office offered to resign after those results came out. Here now, our Seoul correspondent Jean McKenzie with this update.
This is a landslide victory for the opposition parties here in South Korea. Yes, they won a similar number of seats in the last general election back in 2020, but the circumstances were very different. There was a hugely popular liberal president in office at the time. And so this defeat for the ruling party is being seen as a vote of no confidence in the current president, Yoon Suk-yeol, who's been in office for 2 years. It does weaken his authority, even though it might seem on paper that not much has changed when you look at the seats. When it comes to the day-to-day politics, it means that the president is going to struggle to pass votes and push forward with his agenda, because the opposition parties are going to be able to team up to fast-track the laws they like and block the laws they don't. And so it is going to be more difficult for the government to tackle some of the urgent issues that South Korea faces, from rising food prices, a slowing economy, a rapidly aging society. When it comes to foreign policy, the parliament has less say, and so we might see the president focus more on this, as he has done over the past 2 years. He has made some pretty radical changes to foreign policy in his time. He has taken a tough stance on North Korea. He's built up his relationship with the United States and Japan in order to counter North Korea and China. But crucially, he had the authority to do so because he had just won a presidential election. Now he has, in effect, lost an election. That is going to weaken his leadership. It will give him less clout abroad, and it will make it more difficult for him to push ahead with foreign policy that doesn't have popular support here in South Korea.